What's going on, everybody? It's your favorite dating coach, Elliot Scott, and as you can see by the title below, we're going to talk about what I believe is a very, very important video and a very important concept when it comes to being the woman he's talking to and wanting to transition into something more serious, like a relationship, a title, boyfriend, girlfriend, exclusive, monogamous, and things like that. So if you're having trouble transitioning over there, and or if that's something you're really into and you're wanting with this guy, and you're wondering why he's not, this video is for you. I'm going to go into a lot of detail on it. And if you want even more detail, I mean hours of detail, you can check out my course, Attraction Academy, okay? So before we even get into this, there's three pillars that are really important that I think a man looks at when it comes to deciding this girl is the one. Very important pillars. But the first thing I want to talk about, right, so here's the pillars. The first thing I want to talk about is the umbrella, like this all falls under. And that is if the guy is an emotionally available or emotionally unavailable prospect, man. Okay, if he's emotionally available, meaning he wants a relationship, he's looking for one, he's not going to play any games and all that kind of stuff. He's actually looking for a woman to become or to be in a relationship with, and he's emotionally available. Just because he wants a relationship doesn't mean he's emotionally unavailable or emotionally available. Then great, all this is going to work out. If he's an emotionally unavailable guy, so a guy who is newly single, a guy who has recently been cheated on, a guy who hasn't been in a relationship in the last 3, 5, 6, however many years, a guy who has had bad experience with women or has never had a serious, whatever it is. If again, I go like into 25 different examples on my course, Attraction Academy. I highly suggest you get that. But if you think your guy falls in this category, this shit doesn't matter. Listen, you could be the best girl. You could be the most awesome, the prettiest, of this, to that. You could be all these great things. If he's emotionally unavailable, he's going to look at him as more of an asset to take advantage of, to drain and try to have his cake and eat it too, instead of being something to invest in. It's a mindset shift. If a guy is emotionally available and he wants a relationship, it's an investment. If it's an emotionally unavailable guy, it's more of a, I'm going to try to have my cake and eat it too and just drain from you while talking to other women. I always tell my clients, even if you're a nine or a 10, there's some guys out there who rather just have 3 sevens or 3 sixes or 2 sevens than a 9 or than a 10. You got to find out if your guy's that guy, okay? That's not what this video is about. It's about the three pillars. So the first pillar I want to talk about is attraction. And there's a long list of things that go under attraction, okay? And so you can check these off if you want or something like that. I just want to talk about the pillar. And attraction would be your chemistry, your connection, the depth you guys have, the rapport you guys have, your looks, is how attracted he is to you, how different in leagues you guys are. For example, if he's a 9 and you're a 7, probably not going to commit. If it's the other way around and you're a 9 and he's a 7, it's more likely. The sex and things like that. The attraction pillar is a very, 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 very important pillar that, I guess I'm going to talk about two different things here. It's a very important pillar to a man because men are visual, sexual, and physical by nature. However, the caveat with it is a lot of women will come to me and they would say, well, I am better looking than him. I'm way out of his league. He says that, my friends say that, and all that. I'm like, okay, if that's the case, he's still not committing. That starts to make me think emotionally unavailability. But I don't want to jump to that conclusion. What I also tell women is, well, if your value proposition or what he wants most from you is looks or sex, that could be a problem because you're not unique in that sense anymore. You might be better looking, but looks are subjective. There's a lot of good-looking people out there, you know, and there might be people out there who would give it up to him easier. So if you're like I have Instagram models who would come to me saying, I have no problem getting a guy, but I can't keep a guy, Elliot. Why? And I say, well, because your value proposition is sex. Do you have more to offer? Absolutely. Of course you do. That's not what you are. You're not just an object. But if you're like really attractive, okay, and you kind of display it like that, or that's what he mostly is going after, That could be a problem because, again, it's not unique anymore. You're not the only good-looking woman out there. You're not the only one who can offer this thing to him. So he might try to have his cake and eat it too. So yes, while chemistry, rapport, and depth and all that kind of stuff is very important, and I think you should build that too, along with being a good-looking girl, you know, having great chemistry when it comes to sex and things like that. Please, I know so many women who focus so much on looks and focus so much on how they are in the bedroom. Please focus on these other things I'm talking about, rapport, depth, chemistry, you know, all that kind of stuff, and then these other two pillars. Now, the other two pillars can be a little more harsh, but it's just a matter of fact. I think they're needed. The second one is what I call logic, okay? I have it right here, logic. And what logic means to me is things that, a man's logical by nature. It's the things that naturally go through his head. So, for example, long distance. Can that be an issue? Yes, it can, okay? It could be a very big issue. He's logically thinking. When I say logic, I mean like resources are a sense of logic, meaning how many resources am I going to have to invest in this woman to, not that he doesn't want to, it's just a lot of time, energy, effort, you know, things like that. How maintainable or sustainable is this thing that we can have? If it's long distance, it's harder. If she's dramatic, it's harder. If we're very different from each other, it's harder. So one sense of logic is the resources, time, energy, effort, how I can invest and how sustainable this is with her. Another part of logic, and this is kind of the harsh part, but it kind of goes with number one, or the first pillar of looks. It's, is she the best I can get in terms of options, right? Or, that's one of them. Or another one is, does she make me want to be a better person? Or another one is, is my life better with her than without? See, now when you start putting these pieces together, and let's say you're a bomb ass chick with great chemistry, you're good looking, you're like I said, you're great in bed, and then over here, like I said, you live closer to each other, you guys get along really well. You're when it comes to sustainability or assets, you're just like a normal girl. Hey, I just like consistency. I just like communication. That's it. You don't gotta blow up my shit all day, every day. You know, and then on top of that, he feels like he's life is his life is so much better with you in it than without, and it feels like you're so fun to be around, and that I'm happier when I'm with you. If that's the case, don't you think he would want to be with you more than not? Don't you think he would want to keep you in his life? Of course he would. Now, what determines if he's actually going to commit or not in that sense is the emotional unavailability, or if he is emotionally available. Like I said, that's the most important thing. So a lot of you might be watching this and you'll say, Elliot, I got all this shit you're talking about. I got all this stuff. He says, I'm the best looking woman. I'm way out of his league. All my friends say it. You know, I give him the bomb ass sex. He's always having a fun time with me. He's always blowing up my shit. He's always reaching out. He's the one always initiating, but he's not committing. Well, that's probably because he's trying to have his cake and eat it too. There's a reason he's not committing. It's logic, ladies. It's logic. If you're that good and he's not committing, it's one of two things. You're not giving him the ultimatum, so he's not going to throw himself under the bus like that. Or two, he's just trying to have his cake and eat it too. He's not emotionally available. But number two is logic, right? He needs to think logically. Is this sustainable? And is this the best option I can get? I hate to say it like that because it's not always like that. It's not as black and white as that sounds, okay? It's like, okay, I have a better option, therefore everything else is a race. That's not true. It usually comes down to, like, if you just really like somebody, you really like somebody. I don't care if there's a better option out there. I want you. I remember I got out of this relationship way back in the day, 12 years ago, and I really liked the girl personally. I liked her a lot, but my friends were always saying, you can get better. You can get better. You can get better. There's better out there, man. There's better out there. You know, just like your friends and homies will say that kind of shit to you. And I'm like, logically, I know that, guys, I know that. I know there's better out there. The chance of her being the one is one in however billion, right? Like, I know that, but I don't want better. I want her, right? So don't take to heart when I say things like, are you the perfect one for him? Or is there better out there? It's subjective. But he has to have that feeling that you are an ideal candidate, because if you're not, he's just not going to commit. So, again, logic would be things like asking those questions, distance, resources, and things like that. And then, of course, lastly, which I talk about so heavily, in my course Attraction Academy. I talk about it so extensively. Assets versus liabilities. Assets are the things that you are giving a guy, the traits you are giving a guy that a guy wants, and liabilities are the cost, I guess you can say, for those things. So a bad example would be, and I'm not saying this is part of it, this is just a kind of a cost detriment here. Let's say I really want to hook up with a girl, come back around and hook up with the girl. Assets, right? Hooking up with her. I'm very physically attracted to her and I know I can. I know she'll let me back in. All assets, of course, in the shittiest sense. But I don't want to do it because she's fucking crazy, right? She's crazy. She's gonna kill me if I come back around. Or I feel like I'm leading her on if I do so. Or I feel like if I comply to telling her I'm on the same page when I'm not and I don't want to go through this drama or bullshit or hurt her anymore. Those are all costs. Those are all liabilities, right? So when a guy is wanting to commit to it, and I go about this extensive in my course, Attraction Academy. So when a guy wants to get with a girl and think of her as girlfriend material, she has to have, the attraction has to be there. The looks, the chemistry, the depth, the rapport, the connection, things like something he can't get with everyone else. Then she has to have the, what's it called? The law, there has to be the logic. Is it logical for me to do so? And this the assets versus liability kind of ties those two things together. It is an asset that you look good. It is an asset that you're great in bed. It is an asset that you guys have a deep connection. It is an asset that you're patient with him because he tends to have anger issues. It is an asset, again, logically, that you guys live closer together. It is an asset that you guys are great communicators, that you guys don't have to go on these extravagant dates all the time. It is an asset that, you know, you get what I'm saying. An asset are all the good things that he gets from being with you, from dating you, from committing, from progressing, from transitioning from one point to another. A liability is the opposite. High drama, high maintenance, long distance could be one. Long distance can work, but long distance can be one. Me not being sure about a relationship or with you because I'm talking to four other women. That could be a liability because he's like, well, if I'm already having sex with her and it already feels like a relationship, why would I transition into one with you? Because I would actually, like, what would I be gaining? It already feels like a relationship. I'm already hooking up with you. We already have a good connection. If anything, I'd be losing out on things because I can't talk to these other four women, right? So that could be a liability. And things like that. So when the assets are way higher than the liabilities, he thinks of it logically. It logically makes sense to him because you're one of the best options he can get. You guys are close together. You're making him happier, or he's happier with you in his life than without, and things like that. And of course, there's a lot of attraction there. You guys will be happily ever after. And if he does not commit under those circumstances, you know you have an emotionally unavailable guy. Okay. So that being said, ladies, this is a little bit of a longer video, over 13 minutes, but, and I could go on for hours and hours about it. Like I said, it's my course, Attraction Academy, if you want to check it out. Talk about extensively there. But that being said, ladies, I love you all. Take care, and I hope I helped you. Peace.